Flyin Finn Motorsport Rally DVD. In association with Pace Notes Rally Magazine, the UK and Ireland's only dedicated rally publication.
Championship round, do you think it's a good idea? Or
I think it's a good idea. I think maybe the only thing is we're off work today, and we're all kind of thinking of a Saturday, but it was Friday. But it's good because, you know, I think rallying, more people take part on a Saturday. You know, some people don't like rallying on Sunday, so it's good as well for the community that can come out and watch on a Saturday, and we're not interrupting any chapels or churches on the route. So yeah, that's a good thing about it. You know, it's not disturbing anybody's weekly what they're doing. So yeah, it should be good, and I'd say it'll show tomorrow the big crowd it'll turn out here.
And good crack tomorrow night.
Oh, definitely. I think that's why it's on a Saturday night. I think Paul K decided having a Saturday night, so maybe a bit of fun, especially if Tim McNulty comes up.
That's it. Gary Denny's the best of luck this weekend.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Top modified man this weekend, Frank Kelly. Frank, you've been out on the stage today. What do you think of them?
They're challenging. They're a lot of bumps and jumps. I think stage three, particularly, will be the decider in this rally. But we'll have to get through stage one and two. Three times as well, but stage three going towards the end, there's a lot of bumps and jumps, and it'll be a test of a suspension and what VKR set up. So hopefully we have the right setup.
It's a very talented modified entry this weekend. How do you fancy your chances?
It's going to be tough today, tomorrow. We're going to try and battle the class 13 guys, let the rest of them do their own rallying, but you have Sam Smith, Michael Conlon, and your boy Hendy in the twin cam, to name but a few, and there's a lot of quick men there, so if we can fight with them and stay in the top three, if at all possible, I'd be more than happy with that.
And looking up at the sky there, the weather looks a bit changeable. What do you reckon? The weather will play a big part tomorrow?
Oh no, it's going to be sunny and dry, trust me. Slicks all the way.
There you have it, Frank Kelly's the weatherman, has just confirmed it for you folks. Frank, the best of luck this weekend.
Thanks very much.
Number one seed on the road this weekend and buying for a win is Robert Barwell. Robert, how would you find the stages after today's wrecking?
Very tough, quite quick, technical, but they should be okay, they should suit our car, not mad long straights. But no, they're not going to be easy, innit?
especially stage three, it seems to be fairly long. Like,
stage three is quite long, but it is quite fast. We might be at a slight disadvantage, but I don't think we're going to be at that disadvantage. It is quite bumpy, but it's, if we can be flat out on it for the majority of it, we'll be happy enough.
Hoping to put it up to the WRC cars this weekend.
Yeah, we're hoping to put it up to them every weekend, but now this weekend it's going to be tough. Stages are quite technical, there's no room for any error or mistakes. I'd say it could be quite easy to get a puncture and drop a minute, but no, we'll get ourselves bedded in on the first loop and take it from there.
Class 12 superhero this weekend, Dan DeHaren, and then you're out in a new car this weekend.
Yeah, we're going for the win. The win. Not the class, the overall. First, overall.
Robert Barbell said he's quite nervous about you.
Yeah, he should be, because like we are quick, like.
And you got a world class nav as well this weekend.
Well,
voice of an angel.
Voice of an angel, mind of a devil. Yeah.
Rallying, and the progress is absolutely fantastic.